right? C plus plus this pointer. Okay. This pointer. So what is the use of this pointer, right? Use of this pointer. Okay, C plus plus this pointer. Just I am going to copy paste this. Okay, what is the use of the this pointer? Next our topic is this pointer. C plus plus this pointer. It's a this pointer because you are learning the C plus plus. Okay, so I'm going to write here the C plus plus C plus plus. Okay. This pointer in C++, that's it. Okay, so what is the use of this? This pointer, that is refers to the current objects. Okay, it is also the concept in this Java. So this keywords, this pointer is the keyword. This is the keyword, guys. Okay, this is the keyword that refers to the current instance of the class. We can simply say that refer the current object of the class. Okay, instances that refers to the current instance of the class. So there can be the main three use of the this keyword in C++. What will be the uses? Okay, kya three uses hai? You can see here the main three uses of C++ here. Okay, means in C++ use of this pointer, right? It can be used to pass the current object as a parameter to the another method. Okay, as a parameter to the another method, right? So just I am going to explain once again here. Suppose we have the one function, that is what, a get data. Okay, and we are in this class, we are going to declare, suppose A is a class. In this class we are going to declare a data member publicly. Consider it's a publicly data member. Suppose we have the REN and marks, we have just something. Okay, so you have the data member as a float. Okay, so data type is float, integer and float. Okay, two members are there. If you want to take the data by using the argument passing, if you take the data from argument, okay, so what we are going to do here, we are going to use here the get data or any other function, get or get data, whatever it may be. What you are going to take here, get, then you can write here the another variable, that is what, roll number and comma. We are going to take here the float m1 form or something. Okay, so then we are going to what, we are taking the argument, we are taking this argument in the formal variable, right? In this formal variable we are going to take and we are going to assign then. So we are going to write here rn is equal to roll number, okay, and m1 that will be stored into what, marks. Okay, see guys, we do, and in this get function, means a get data function, in the main function we are going to pass some arguments. Okay, so like this way we are going to pass some arguments. Okay, so it is going to store here as an argument, passing as an argument, it is going to be stored here in the formal parameters and it will assign to the regular variables. Okay, that is available in the class, right? It's a temporary variables you are going to see here. Okay, formal parameters, right? It's a argument passing, right? You are going to pass, but we cannot write here, we cannot write here. Okay, so aryan aryan and your marks. Okay, we can't write this aryan is equal to aryan. Okay, aryan is equal to aryan, marks is equal to mark, right? So to remove these things, okay, so if you want to access like this, so we are going to use here what, this keyword. How can access this? By using this keyword. Okay, this pointer. So if you want to access this, then you can use this like this way, right? But using the this pointer, that can be possible to access this. Okay, so it can be used to pass the current object as a parameter to the another method. Okay, it's a current object, now it is referred as a current parameters. Okay, so it can be used to refer the current class instance variable. It can be used to declare indexer. Okay, can be indexer, it is work as indexer, right? So we can access using this keyword as a this pointer. So let us see the one example of this pointer. Okay, so find here this example of this pointer, program number 89, save as, Okay, program number 89. Okay, so it's an example of this pointer. This is the keyword that's referred to the field of current or class. Okay, that's referred the field of current class. See the example, this class example. Example of this pointer example. Okay, now see here, so can write here a hash include IO stream. Okay, then using the namespace, standard, right? Then you can take the one class, that is what student, suppose. Okay, the same program we are taking here. So the publicly you can write, okay, so publicly you can declare the data field publicly integer rn for the roll number. Okay, so float for here the marks, and a string that is used for name, for storing the name of student. So here we are going to write the constructor student. Okay, because of we are going to access the current, you are going to access here the current instances using the these keywords, right? So the same thing I am going to write here rn, okay, as a constructor. A float marks, same variable name we are writing here. Okay, then a string and a name. Now we can access, no problem. Okay, so here using the this keyword, okay, as a this pointer, we can refer to the current objects. This then variable name is what, first roll number is equal to rn, that's it. Okay, okay, simple way. This then pointer, what is the next, float marks, okay, is equal to what, marks, then this roll number marks name is equal to what, name. Okay, so here we are going to accessing, means we are going to pass this using arguments. Okay, main method mein usko value pass karenge. Now want to display, okay, want to display, yes, so we can use to display one function, we can use show data, okay, show function, whatever. So now we can print here the cout student details. Okay, so name of the student, right here, name of the student. Okay, name of the student, that is stored in this name variable. Okay, name variable, so you can write here and l. Okay, copy paste, yes, copy paste this thing. Okay, name of student, roll number of student. Right, roll number of student. Now, marks of student. Marks of student, that's it. Okay, next, close. Okay, end of this class. Now come to the main class. Okay, int main, right, create an object. Okay, it's a constructor, constructor automatically call. Okay, so it is instantiated. Okay, so student pass here values. What is the first roll number? Suppose 101 is the roll number. Then marks, something marks you are going to passing here. Okay, the name. So in this saying double quote, you have to pass the name. Right? Can write your name, no problem. So I am writing my name. Okay. Then end. Okay. Now call this show function. Okay. Now call the show function to display that result. Okay. Now this program is okay. Okay. So it is working this keyword. Okay. It's a this keyword referring this to object. So the same variable you have parameter is passing here, right? Same parameter iron mars name, same parameters are here. Okay, so argument passing here. Okay, we are passing the arguments, formal parameter, right? So this is used by using the this keyword, this pointer. Okay, this is the use of this pointer. That's it. See the output. What is that? Name of the student is equal to this, roll number of student is equal to this, and marks of student is equal to this. Okay, why? What is the problem here? Okay, why? Because you are printed name, name, name. That's it. That's why. Okay, so roll number of student, what is the name of variable? Okay, what is the name of variable? This, right? Then you can write here, what is the marks of student? Okay, in which variable it is storing marks. Okay, now compile and execute. Okay, yes.